Okay, Romans 8:16. Jehovah's Witnesses actually teach for this special group of Christians that they will have a mystical feeling that they are one of God's children. If you don't have this feeling, you are not one of God's children. Therefore, you are not in this special group.
So the first group are the sons of God.
Right.
But the second group are
friends of God. So Romans chapter 8 was the chapter that led me out of the organization because of verses 9 and 10. I saw that this applies to anyone who no longer wants to live in sin and wants to be led by the Spirit. No one has the right to take this away from a person. As I started to see, you can either live in sin or you can be led by the Spirit. Verse 14 says, "For all who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God." This increased my faith. They teach you to pray for God's Holy Spirit, but yet you're denied the power of the Holy Spirit to be a son of God. It doesn't make any sense. Verse 29, talking of Jesus, he was the firstborn of many brothers. I started to see that the life that Jesus had could be a life that I also could have. I too could be led by the Spirit and have victory over sin. Looking at chapter 8, it really blew my mind. This was something in the organization we didn't talk about, being born again. I didn't come to this understanding until after I left. John chapter 3, verse 3 says we must be born again. And that means now. The people that come to your door, they still believe that they are Christians. But the vast majority of the witnesses that come to your door are not considered born again or anointed. And they see no problem with that because they are a part of God's one true organization, as they say. The Jehovah's Witness leadership has taught millions of people to be afraid to do outside research. That is very deceptive. Don't ever be afraid to research and test all things. We can pray for the courage and the boldness to test these things and to just start from the beginning and take your time. A good foundation would be to start on what Jesus taught and who he is.